Okay, chapter 21, point 2, voltage and energy transfer. Last chapter, 21.1, we know that what is the definition of the current. And also we know that the type of the circuit, open circuit, closed circuit. And also, and we know that the measuring device for it will be the ammeter. In this topic, we will focus on the voltage. What is the meaning of voltage and also the energy transfer and also the voltmeter? We will consider it in this session. Now, let's to start. Part A, energy transfer in a circuit. As we know that we have the battery or cells. Inside it, we have the chemical energy to drive and to drive the charge through the circuit. Of course, through the closed circuit. In it, we can see the energy exchange from chemical energy into electrical energy. Now, in this, we will focus on what are they. We will distinguish different parts in it. Power sources, it means that the energy provider. The loads, it means that the energy consumer. To help the energy source to transfer the energy to the energy consumer, it means that the loads, we should have the connecting conductors. This one may be the wire, or maybe the resistor, or maybe motor and like that. Okay, but of course the motor should be the loads. The resistor also a load. So in order to do it, should be the copper wire. Okay, now try to understand what are they. Starting from the power source. For example, maybe the battery. We have positive and negative terminal. You can link up together, connect together in series. Okay, like that. And here, supplies electrical energy. Not a source of charge. Okay, all the charges should be inside each material, including the copper wire. Inside the copper wire, we have the charge. It means that we have the electrons. Actually, inside the chemical cell, we also have the charge. So, once again, battery can provide energy, electrical energy. Of course, this energy is coming from the chemical energy. And this one is not charge provider. Okay, not a charge provider. This one just only energy provider. But look at this. This one is an analog. Lui bei. So look at this. For example, pull gently. Okay. Like that. To let it rotate. It means that you supply energy. On the other hand, we just only put a finger on it to feel that you have the friction on your finger. Then this one will be dissipating energy. 浪费能量. 那边供应能量. Okay. This one, inside the actual circuit, exactly the same. We have the supplying energy. The energy provider in it will be the battery. Okay, this one provide energy. And then the light bulb will consume energy. But how? We should have the charges. Okay, inside it, inside the whole circuit, the complete circuit, inside it, we have the charge fold. In this, in part B, we will focus on it, how energy can be transferred from one place to the other place. This one should be related to a certain physical quantities. So in part B, we will define these physical quantities to govern the energy transfer inside the closed circuit. What is it? Will be the voltage. This one is the definition of voltage. What is the voltage? 中文就叫做什么呢? 叫做volt, 即是它的unit就是volt volt就是瓦特 okay? 这个就会叫做电压的voltage. By definition, what is it? Should be the electrical energy transferred per unit charge. 每一粒charge 它可以carry到多少能量走 这个叫voltage. the unit of it is watt. Okay, 又係啲科學家啦嚇. So, here we have two different watts. One is the energy supplier. Okay, this one. Energy supplied to the circuit per unit charge by a power source, for example, the battery or the cell. Then this one is the definition. W is the electrical potential energy, and Q will be the charge in it. This battery can provide W energy, and this energy will give into the charge. The charge will carry this W energy based on EMF. EMF stands for electromotive force. Once again, F is force, because 100 or 200 years ago, this one, we do not know that what is the voltage, okay? In this environment, we just didn't know that the force. So everything should be related to the force. Similar to the EHT, extra high tension power supply. Okay, and now look at this. This one, what is the meaning of 1.5 watt? 1.5 watt means that for each coulomb, per one coulomb, the battery can give 1.5 joule to the charge to carry it out of the battery. Okay, 電壓, 這個1個 電壓 代表什麼意思呢? 就代表1個 coulomb 的 charge 個電芯可以壓到1個joule的能量給它, 這個叫做電壓。 因此啦, 每一個 coulomb 的 charge 將會擁有1個joule的能量。 Okay, 這件事就叫做1W的電壓。 記住電壓就像心臟的boom, 如果電壓越高, 即是每一粒 charge 所儲到的能量就越高。 Okay? And then, this one is EMF, okay? But on the other hand, we will have a potential difference. Okay? What is the definition of potential difference? Will be similar to this. Okay, EMF means that energy supplied. Okay, but how about potential difference? Potential difference in it, we will say that V and then W over Q. Actually, the formula is exactly the same, but the definition is not the same. Per unit charge, we will consume W energy. Then, this one, we will say that potential difference. 這個叫電壓差. 什麼意思呢? 有一個 coulomb 的 charge 經過, 例如一個 light bulb, okay? 一個 charge, 一個 coulomb 的 charge 經過個 light bulb, 那個 light bulb 呢, 就會浪費了1個 joule 的能量. 如果這樣的話, 即經過個 light bulb 之後, 電壓 呢, 就會下降 1個W. 記住, 一件 epsilon 就代表 energy supply, okay? From the source. 一件 V 呢, 就代表 psi 能量, 每 psi 到 能量, 它的電壓 就越來越低, 這個叫做電壓差, okay?